Alright, so we are going to start this off by taking off the makeup that I was too lazy to take off last night before I went to bed. Just wiping myself down with a makeup wipe. Now I'm going to get this hair out of my face because I cannot stand putting makeup on with hair in my face, because then all my foundation gets into my makeup and it is the biggest pain in the butt. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is moisturize my face. I don't know why I'm telling y'all everything I'm doing because this is not a makeup tutorial. But I'm moisturizing my face so that way my skin don't get dry and nasty. And I got some in my hair, just don't pay any attention to that. And now we're gonna use primer. I use the Rimmel London Stay Matte Face Primer because it keeps my makeup on all day and it doesn't make me look greasy, even though I cancel that out by using highlighter, because highlighter kind of makes you look greasy. It takes me about 15 minutes to get this stuff on my face because I have such a big face. Don't pay no mind to that. Now we're going to use foundation. I use Maybelline Fit Me in shade 125, which is too dark for my face, but I'd rather have too dark than too light, because if you use foundation that's too dark, at least you can highlight it. If you use foundation that's too light, then you just look dead. So I like to use something that makes my face look a little more awake and gives me a little bit of a tan effect. And I also blend it in really well so it doesn't look like my face is completely mismatched with the rest of my body. And I just blend my foundation in with this little beauty blender that I bought off of Amazon. And I like to make really stupid faces while I am putting my foundation on. I also like to do stupid little dances and then question why I did that in the first place. Now I blend it down my neck so again you don't see a harsh makeup line between your face and your neck. If I'm really feeling risky and want to wear a shirt that's kind of low cut, I'll also put it on my chest. Fun fact of the day, I put makeup on my chest so I don't look so pale. And I'm dancing again. Why do I keep doing that? Alright, I really need to stop. That's not even cute. And now I use concealer to highlight my under eyes and hide them eye bags because I don't sleep. And I just do it kind of like in a fan shape, that way it blends in better and it hides my dark circles better than if you would just dot it underneath your eyes. And I just blend that all together. I think every woman on the planet makes really unattractive faces when they're doing makeup. Me especially. And now I'm gonna take the concealer and put it on my forehead to highlight. Put it on my Cupid's bow and on my chin. Again, it's just to highlight the areas that I want highlighted and make stupid faces. Again. Now we blend some more. And we blend and we blend until we can't blend anymore. Girl, stop. And now I take my Airspun setting powder and I bake my under eyes to keep my concealer from creasing, and it also helps set the highlight and the concealer under your eyes. I've accidentally left the house with my bake on my face before. Fun fact. And then I'm just going to take a brush and set the rest of my face with the same Airspun translucent powder. girl, no. And the next thing I'm gonna do is my eyebrows, and this is the long part. I take a spoolie and I brush out my eyebrows and make stupid faces again. And then I take the NYX Tame and Frame Waterproof, it's kind of like a dip brow, and a little angle brush from e.l.f. and fill in my eyebrows. And my eyebrows are also two different shapes and two different like sizes, so I kind of have to match one to the other one, or else I'll walk around looking like an idiot. My eyebrows also don't grow the way that they're supposed to, so I do extend them out a little bit toward my nose, where normal people have eyebrows. And if I keep rolling my eyes, it's not because I'm actually rolling my eyes, it's because I have dry eyes contacts. And when filming this, I didn't realize that I was blocking off half my face, so please don't pay any mind to that. There we go, one eyebrow done. I don't remember why I made that face, but I think it's because I picked up so much of that dip brow that it was just a huge chunk on my brush. And 15 minutes later, we are still filling in eyebrows. Also, when going toward the inner part of my eyebrows, I like to kind of go up and down with it. That way it makes little hair-like looking lines. And so it doesn't look completely drawn on, even though it is. And now we're done. And the next thing I'm going to do is brush away my bake. So that way I don't walk around with white powder under my eyes all day and I'm dancing again. I need to stop doing that. The next thing I'm going to do is use that bronzer palette by Wet n Wild and just bronze up my cheeks. Get a little contour going on. And that brush is a Real Techniques brush. I don't think it's supposed to be for contour, but I use it for that anyway because I don't follow the rules. Someone please tell me why I keep making them faces, because I don't know. And then the next thing I'm going to do is contour my big ass forehead and try to make it look a little smaller, even though it never works. It works for people on the internet, but it does not work for me. But I do it anyway. And now I'm going to use blush. I use this Wet n Wild blush that I've been having for about 2 years because I didn't know, you know, what the purpose of blush was for a long time, but now I use it. Yeah, I like to apologize for the lighting in this video. The lighting is kind of bad because I use a lamp, so if it goes in and out and bothers you guys, I'm sorry. And now I'm going to highlight. I don't remember what this highlighter is called, and I don't feel like going to get up to look, but I got it off of Walmart.com, and it is the greatest thing I have ever gotten in my life. Look at that shine, girl. Yes. See, even I agree. We are just illuminating my face with this little brush I got from an Ipsy bag. It's supposed to be a contour brush, but again, I don't follow the rules. And I just highlight my forehead, and I highlight my Cupid's bow and my chin. And now the next thing I'm going to do is put some translucent powder under my contour line to make a sharper cheekbone effect. I don't really see the difference, but I saw it on YouTube videos, and I do whatever I see on the internet. And there's that lighting again. Girl, yas. No, stop, stop. No, oh, why? Stop doing that. Okay, the next thing I'm gonna do is prime my eyelids, and I use the NYX eyeshadow primer, which again, I don't know the exact name of it. And then I set it with a little bit of translucent powder just so the eyeshadow, I want it to stick, but not stick too much. So I use this little e.l.f. brush to put translucent powder on my eyelids. And the next thing I'm going to use is the Coastal Scents 252 palette in that kind of burnt orangish color. I like to use that to warm up my eyelids. And I use this little blending brush that, again, I got in an Ipsy bag because I don't actually shop for makeup brushes. And I'm just going to put that kind of on the outer corner of my eyes and above my eyelid and just blend it out. And now I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. If you're wondering what that is on my face, I use scotch tape to make a more defined line for my eyeshadow. Again, beauty hack I saw on YouTube. And then I forgot to do this after I did my eyebrows, but I just take this little e.l.f. brush and a sparkly white eyeshadow, and I highlight under my brow bone just to kind of make my eyebrows pop a little bit more. And to give the eyeshadow more of a blended effect, like a gradient effect on my eyelids. And then I'm gonna use this dark color in this palette that I don't know what it's called because I've been having it for so long. Use that dark maroon color and kind of blend it in with the original color to create kind of like a burnt, reddish, orangish, brownish, I don't even know color. And then put a little bit on my eyelid itself. By the way, y'all, this is my first time recording a voiceover, so if I sound stupid, you know, it's okay. And I'm still blending and still blending and blending. I'm going to blend my life away. People wonder why my makeup takes so long. It's because I blend. And now that that's over with, oh, nope, there I go, still blending. Now we're done. The next thing I'm gonna do is take that same brush I used to highlight my under eye and take a plain light tannish color and put it all over the rest of my eyelids. And that's it. Maybe. I don't know. The lighting makes it hard to see. I can't even tell. No, I think I'm still eyeshadowing in the other eye. Girl, yas! Now you take the tape off. And now we're gonna brush away our cheek bake and kind of blend that in a little bit because, as you can see, it left a line. There you go. And now I just took that same red color and a little brush and put some under my eye and smoked it out. And now I'm gonna take this Wet n Wild something eyeliner pencil and do my upper waterline. Cause that's a pet peeve of mine, is when people don't do that and all you see is like pink under their eyeball where eyeliner's supposed to be. And then I'm gonna take a Wet n Wild liquid eyeliner and line my eyes. If y'all haven't tried Wet n Wild makeup, girl, please go try it because that stuff really is the bomb. I think the eyeshadow palette I use is Wet n Wild also. I don't remember. Then you go, you know, make that wing. I know you're not supposed to pull your eyeball, but that's the only way I can get it to go straight. And there you go, you have eyeliner. I was too lazy to show me doing both eyes. And now I'm going to line my waterline with the same Wet n Wild eyeliner pencil. That's so cringy to look at. And now I take this LA Colors Matte Liquid Lipstick that I just recently discovered, because I've been on the hunt for a good nude liquid lipstick that does not cost $25 like Kat Von D does, even though I ain't gonna lie, I got a little Kat Von D in my makeup bag, and just put it all over my lips. I never use lip liner, partly because I don't have any, not because I have a valid excuse not to use lip liner. There we go. That's your lips. And now we're going to curl our eyelashes to get ready to apply mascara. I was going to try to put on some false lashes for this video, but it honestly takes me 15 minutes because I am really bad at putting on fake lashes. So we're just going to go with mascara. And I'm dancing. God, why did I do that? Okay. So we're going to take this Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara, which is my new favorite, and put it all over our top and bottom eyelashes. And I got it on my face. The funny part is that I keep dancing, but I wasn't even listening to music. I was watching Shane Dawson's conspiracy theory videos. Fun fact of the day. And bam, those are your lashes. Now we're gonna take the e.l.f. makeup setting spray and spray it all over your face. And then we are done. That is our makeup of the day. You're looking cute and illuminated and beautiful. Thank y'all for watching. Have a good day.
Bye.